After 2 years of preparation, Apple and Samsung began their face-off in a Silicon Valley courtroom Tuesday. Apple is looking for more than $2 billion for repeated patent infringements by Samsung. Our own Martyn Williams was in the courtroom this week for the opening statements. Martyn, what exactly is Apple accusing Samsung of?
The court case began in 2012. Apple is accusing Samsung of infringing five of its patents on software actions in cell phones. As part of the case, Samsung has countersued Apple on two of its own patents as well. But the real crux of this are these five patents. They include things like a swipe to unlock, which is when your cell phone is asleep and you swipe your finger across the screen to unlock it. That's something that the iPhone had first, and we did see later in some models of phone. So that's one of the patents that's under contention in this case. Another one of them is the sort of spell checker, the word suggestion when you're typing a word. If you misspell something, the telephone will give you suggestions on different spellings that you might have meant. That's another one of the things that's under question in this case.
What do Apple and Samsung's case rely on? What are they talking about on either side?
Well, most of this last 2 years has been spent on preparation for the case, as you said, and some of that on a process called discovery, where either side is allowed to request emails and internal documents from each company. So yesterday we saw some internal documents. Samsung presented some internal documents from Apple, including an email from Steve Jobs ahead of an executive presentation that he was doing at a management retreat, where he was calling apparently for a holy war against Google. That's important because one of Samsung's arguments is that a lot of the software in the phones was actually programmed by Google, not by Samsung itself, and also to show that Android was actually a threat to Apple. On the other side, Apple is showing internal Samsung documents from just after the iPhone came out, when there really does appear to have been some sort of crisis within Samsung about how well Apple was doing. And in many cases, Apple was comparing its phones and its new designs specifically to the iPhone. So it does, hopefully in Apple's lawyer's eyes, that will help convince the jury that Samsung was out just to copy the iPhone.
And there are no cameras in the courtroom, so tell everyone out there, what does it look like inside? Does one company have more lawyers than the other?
It's a little bit different to those courtrooms you see on television. Judge Koh is, of course, sitting at the head of the room. We have an 8-person jury on one side, and then each side has about 10 lawyers. There's usually only one or two lawyers standing and arguing at any one time. And then a sort of little bank of technical guys that are in charge of showing the exhibits, which come up on big screens, and maybe playing videos if that's needed. And then just behind that, we've got a couple of rows of Samsung and Apple-related attorneys or people from the companies in the sort of audience seats. And then one side has journalists, the other side members of the public, or in the case of this particular trial, we have representatives from other companies and other legal firms that maybe have an interest in specifically what's going on in this courtroom.
Do you think we can expect some high-profile testimony? I know that Phil Schiller's taken the stand. What about Tim Cook, maybe?
Yeah, Tim Cook wasn't on the witness list, so we know that he won't be appearing. At the moment, it looks like Phil Schiller might be the biggest name in terms of just sort of general name recognition out there. But we are expecting to hear, or we hope we'll hear from maybe some of the iPhone designers, also some Samsung executives in the United States. But generally, these are people whose names you probably don't know. But maybe we'll have interesting stories to tell and interesting testimony about how some of this happened back 2-3 years ago when the phones under question were being developed.
Any ideas on how long this trial will last?
Yeah, the trial is taking place 3 days a week on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Fridays. We're expecting to hear closing arguments around April 29th, so the end of the month. After that, the jury will begin their daily deliberations. And judging from the last couple of trials that have happened between Apple and Samsung on different patents, but kind of in the same area, we can expect the jury to deliberate for maybe between 2 to 4 days. But as usual with the jury, I mean, it could be done in a day. It could take 2 weeks. We really won't know once the deliberations begin.
All right. Martyn Williams in San Francisco. Continue to keep us posted.
Thanks, Nick.